Hey there, welcome back to the channel. In today's video we are going to look at the best and worst of this week's episode of WWE SmackDown. We are also going to look at the following WWE news and rumors: Becky Lynch's return upon us, Brock Lesnar's return delayed, and Roman Reigns sends a threat to another WWE legend. Before we get into it, we have a question for you. Are you a fan of AEW? Well, we are huge fans of AEW, and we are enjoying the competition it is bringing on the table every week. So with that being said, we have started a channel that focuses on all the latest and exclusive AEW news, rumors and theories. This is gonna be an elite journey, be sure to check it out. The link is in the description box below. Let's not waste any more of your time, and let's get right into the best and worst of this week's episode of SmackDown. WWE SmackDown is still the same as it has always been: fast-paced, easy to watch, with a few inherent booking issues. It's clearly the best weekly product the company puts out, as it feels significant, has a sense of purpose, and does not drag on endlessly like its Monday night counterpart. If you're going to watch WWE SmackDown based on this review, we recommend that you go right ahead. It's certainly one of the best ways to spend your Friday night if you're watching television. Of course, your views are welcome. Sound off in the comments below and let us know your thoughts about WWE SmackDown this week. Number 1, Best. WWE SmackDown star Jay goes missing. Okay, who else was surprised at the sight of Jimmy standing next to Roman Reigns after the main event? Something wasn't right about the visual, and a lot of fans even anticipated an attack. The best kind of stories are the ones where you do not have all the answers, and certainly, the mystery of where Jay is one such conundrum. Will he return to WWE SmackDown and align himself with his cousin and brother again? Or will he embark on a new route? So many questions lie unanswered right now. Rey Mysterio vs. Roman Reigns may have been the WWE SmackDown main event this week, but the real highlight was the Inoue family drama. It may be the best thing in wrestling at the moment. Number 1, Worst, Rey Mysterio just gives up. Yes, WWE SmackDown wants to portray Roman Reigns as invincible and bulletproof, but sometimes there needs to be a semblance of common sense. A father out to avenge his son will not tap out, whatever the odds may be. The main event was great, but the finish was marred by this odd decision. Imagine your favorite movie star giving up when the villain makes things tough for him or her. Also, Roman Reigns is the best thing going on in WWE right now. For him not to be a part of Hell in a Cell is just ridiculous. The WWE SmackDown main event should have happened at this weekend's pay-per-view. Number 2, Best. The WWE SmackDown Women's Championship match got bigger. The only consolation is that the WWE SmackDown Women's Championship match will be contested inside Hell in a Cell. Bianca Belair hasn't felt like a big deal since WrestleMania, and this match should rectify things. Bayley and Belair should have a classic for the ages when the Cell descends. The much-depleted WWE SmackDown Women's division needs this match. Number 2, Worst. Otis' fall from grace. Man, somehow serious Otis on WWE SmackDown just falls short. Remember how popular he was as the lovable goofy big guy, once upon a time? When Vince McMahon believed in him and awarded him the Money in the Bank briefcase, beardless Otis is a pale shadow of his former gimmick. Just compare him to his previous avatar. Number 3, Best and Worst, will WWE SmackDown superstar King Corbin be repackaged? It's always great to see Nakamura win big. The only issue is that he's won a childish feud over a crown. This is the only reason why this entry is in the best and worst column, but it could lead to some interesting possibilities. Could we see a brand new Baron Corbin? The former Lone Wolf character had an edge that the current WWE SmackDown King gimmick did not seem to have. Could Corbin bring back or introduce a more realistic, less over-the-top character for WWE SmackDown fans going forward? WWE Universal Champion Roman Reigns crushed Rey Mysterio in the first-ever Hell in a Cell match on SmackDown. Rey came out tonight looking to exact revenge upon the Tribal Chief for hurting his son Dominic. Unfortunately, he came up short as Roman Reigns left him as a heap on the ground before wishing him a happy Father's Day. Following his dominant victory, Roman Reigns sent Rey Mysterio a threatening message on Twitter: "Go home, stay home, and if you come back to my ring, you'll acknowledge me," tweeted Roman Reigns. It certainly was a one-sided affair by Roman Reigns towards the end of what was an incredible match. Rey Mysterio will have no choice. but to acknowledge the head of the table once he returns to SmackDown. At this point, it looks like there is almost no one on SmackDown who can take on Roman Reigns. The WWE Universal Champion is an indomitable force, and no one knows who can stand up to him. This raises the question as to what exactly WWE has planned for Roman Reigns in the coming months. It is believed that Roman Reigns' opponents for WWE's biggest pay-per-views SummerSlam and WrestleMania could be John Cena and The Rock. Fully aware of the development, the Tribal Chief sent a message to both men, cautioning them from coming back to WWE. The idea is to have Roman Reigns face John Cena at SummerSlam before eventually having the family face-off between himself and The Rock at WrestleMania. Who do you think Roman Reigns' next opponent should be? Share your thoughts with us in the comments section below. It was almost a given that Brock Lesnar would be returning at SummerSlam this year. Multiple reports from various outlets have hinted at the former WWE champion making his return with WWE Universe, however, according to Dave Meltzer of the Wrestling Observer newsletter, the chances of Brock Lesnar returning at SummerSlam are slim. Instead, the journalist believes the Beast Incarnate could return for the Saudi Arabian pay-per-view later this year, he said. While there are a lot of rumors regarding the return of Lesnar, as of June 15, there was no deal for him to return imminently. Of course, it always could happen, especially with the Saudi show late in the year and next year's Mania. SummerSlam would also make sense, but right now that's still not anything agreed to nor expected at this point. Brock Lesnar has not been on WWE TV ever since he dropped the title to Drew McIntyre at WrestleMania 36. Reports suggested Brock Lesnar would be going after Bobby Lashley after his return to the ring. While some reports suggest Roman Reigns is also a possible opponent, the Tribal Chief is expected to face another returning WWE legend, John Cena. Bobby Lashley faces Drew McIntyre at Hell in a Cell, and Roman Reigns went up against Rey Mysterio inside Hell in a Cell on SmackDown. Becky Lynch was at the WWE Performance Center this week as she edged closer to her WWE return. The former WWE Women's Champion has been out of action since May 2020 when she was pregnant. As per PW Insider and Fightful Select, Becky Lynch made an appearance at the Performance Center this week, however. She was not involved in any training, but took part in live matches. Fightful added that WWE's women's division hopes the return of Becky Lynch sees the booking improved for all. They also report the former champion looked jacked and like she never left. WWE are reportedly keen to bring Becky Lynch to the ring this year. She gave birth to her and Seth Rollins' daughter, Rue, in December 2020, and a return has been on the cards for some time. Sheamus was asked earlier this month about Becky Lynch, and he gave no hint of her returning anytime soon. Speaking to Vibe and Wrestling, he said, "Becky to me is like a sister, she really is. I love her to bits. I'm super close to her. She went out there and she made herself. There is no doubt about it. She wasn't in the radar. She went out there every week, she tore it down and she made herself relevant despite the booking. The cream always rises to the top. And that's exactly what happened for her," Sheamus continued. "She went down there and was herself and did what she believed in. I think we're definitely missing her. She's a superstar. She's up there with her with the greats of the past and the greats of the future. I don't know when she's gonna come back. I'm not gonna ask her. It's none of my business to ask her that or what the plan is for the future, but I think, going into live events with fans, we'd love to have her back, again. I've no idea. I miss her, and I know everybody else missed her too, so everyone's excited if she does come back or when she does come back. That question can only be answered by her." There are no reports on when Becky Lynch will be making her return to the ring, but with Stephanie McMahon claiming there are surprises planned for SummerSlam, the pay-per-view could see the return of the man. Oh hey, you are still here. Don't forget to check out the Elite Wrestling News. Thanks for watching, until next time, peace.